Keith in the Bronx. What's up, Keith?
Mr. Francesa, welcome back.
What's happening?
So, obviously, any criticism of the Yankees right now is nitpicking, but...
Well, I mean, you're allowed. Go ahead.
You know, just thinking of what cost them in the Astros series last year and what potentially could be a fatal flaw, you know, thinking ahead to later this year, Sanchez's defense really is such a problem, and it's amazing that it hasn't cost them a game during this run. You know, you had him causing Seve to throw an extra 10, 15 pitches last night. Sunday, Yanks would have been down 2-0, not 4-0, if it was Roman behind the plate, got crossed up with Chapman the night before. It seems like it's something different, or not something different, the same thing every single day, every single night. And my proposal, you know, we're already there with the personal catcher for Gray. Obviously, that's got to be the, you know, approach for Gray for now. I think Roman has got to catch for 50% of the games, and you stick Sanchez at DH, and it sends a message that he's got to get better. Roman is an underrated, underutilized player. You know, he's not an automatic out. He's a great receiver. And, you know, every time they've given him a shot, he's hit a little bit. He's hit in the clutch. And if you just keep rolling Sanchez out there day after day, I don't see how he improves. I think you need to, you know, make a statement that it is a problem and, you know, give some motivation for him to earn the catching time that, you know, he's not playing like he deserves. And, you know, he would be the best full-time DH in all of baseball. And I think it also sends a message that that is a real possibility if this doesn't improve. What do you think, Mike?
There's some truth to what you're saying. His bat, having his bat like his at the catcher spot gives you an incredible offensive advantage in your lineup versus the other team. Because to have a player, no one's fielding a catcher that hits like that. So, I mean, he is such a wondrous hitter for a catcher. He's a tremendous hitter for anybody. It's almost like a Mike Piazza situation again. Mike's problem was he was slow to set up, which cost him dearly. Sanchez has a very good arm. His problem's not in the setup. His problem's with the glove. He does not have a good glove. He's got a very, very inconsistent glove. He has a habit of boxing balls. He has a habit of letting balls go off the edge of his glove, come out of the web. He gets trouble sometimes reading where the ball is going to bounce. He doesn't do a good job of shifting his body very quickly. So he's got some issues back there defensively. No one's going to dispute it. And he does have a good throwing arm. He's a very good throwing arm, as a matter of fact. And I don't think his calling of the game is anything to worry about. But I think his ability to use the glove, just the glove, is his Achilles heel. I mean, that is his weakness, and that's what he's got to work on. He has to work on the glove. He's got to work on being a softer receiver. He's got to do a better job of framing pitches. But more than that, he's got to do a better job of making sure he catches the ball and keeping the ball in front of him. The Mets caught a very big break in the inning where Wheeler got out of it in the sixth because the catcher actually had missed the ball and it hit the umpire. If it didn't hit the umpire, they would have scored a run, the Reds there. So they actually caught a break there. Sometime you do, you know. Tom in Riverhead, what's up, Tom?
Hey, Mike, welcome back.
Thank you. What's happened?
Mets culture. Do you think the